Addicted to love. New research of the brain shows losing a lover can have the same effect as trying to kick an addiction. Joining us this morning, biological anthropologist Dr. Helen Fisher, the first and first author of the Love Addiction Study. Good to have you with us this morning.
I'm delighted.
You say this is the most important work you've done.
Absolutely, yes. In 35 years, I've studied the brain for a long time. But, I mean, when you're rejected in love, I mean, people pine for love, they live for love, they kill for love, they die for love.
But is it really, I mean, you hear love addiction, but it doesn't seem to, I mean, is it love or is it just an attraction? How do you know it's really love that you're addicted to?
Well, you can't stop thinking about this person. You crave the person. You do inappropriate things. You distort reality. You lie in bed and cry. You drink too much. You drive too fast. You do very inappropriate things when you've been rejected in love. And they're all things associated with addiction.
So these are real. This is a real serious addiction, which you say is right up there with similar to a cocaine addiction.
Well, what we did is we put 15 people who had just been rejected into a brain scanner, and we found activity in a brain pathway that is exactly the same brain pathway that becomes activated when you are profoundly addicted to cocaine, and another region associated with nicotine addiction, and also brain regions associated with intense romantic love, physical pain, and deep attachment. So you're craving this person, you're madly in love with him, you're deeply attached to him, you're in physical pain, and you are obsessed with somebody.
So physical pain, and it can make you act out and do certain things as well. So how does it influence your behavior specifically?
Well, I do think that you can't get to work, you can't get to sleep, you don't eat, you drink too much, you drive too fast, you can be dangerous to yourself and to everybody around you.
Are there any sort of parameters, though, for knowing when you've crossed the line to just being lovesick, infatuated, to a true addiction, which can cause a number of problems for you and others?
Well, I think, you can slip into clinical depression and not get out of bed. You cannot get to work. You don't call your family or your friends. You show up at the gym where he is or she is. You do all kinds of inappropriate things. And so, of course, the thing is to treat it as an addiction. I mean, get rid of the cards and letters.
But there isn't really love rehab. So what? So how do besides getting rid of things around the house, how do you actually treat it?
Well, I think you've got to don't ruminate. Don't lie in bed. Somebody's camping in your head. Don't lie around and ruminate about what went on. Go out with friends. Get hugs. That drives up oxytocin in the brain. Mm-hmm. Get some exercise. That drives up dopamine in the brain. Makes you feel better. Don't call. Don't write. Don't be anywhere near this person. And if you're going to take any kind of antidepressants, get off of them as soon as you can. So, because a lot of these blunt the emotions, and you want to go find the next person. That's the real key. Time heals, by the way. We did find that a brain region associated with deep attachment becomes less and less active the farther you get away from the lover.
Yes. It's just getting to that point that that's the hard part. Yeah. Dr. Helen Fisher, good to have you with us this morning. Thanks.
Yeah, thank you.